and I was very excited about meeting this prophet.
New Zealander Grace Adams told her story on American network television for the very first time to 48 Hours. In 1990, Grace, who was 29, and her younger sister Rebecca, just 21, made the exhausting 7,500-mile journey, arriving at the Waco compound at about 11 at night. Grace says they walked into a hellish scene.
David was on stage on a hospital bed, and he was yelling and screaming and cussing.
And were there children in the room?
Yes, there were children. He had a boat paddle, and he was hitting that boat paddle on the stage. I'm thinking, who is this man? I'm thinking, well, what did we come to?
But Grace Adams says there were plenty of sexual targets at the compound.
As a woman, you needed to have sex with David in order to go to heaven.
And Grace Adams insists it wasn't just the adult women.
What kind of ages are we talking about?
I'm talking 12 plus.
Any get pregnant by him?
Yes.
Grace says she was terrified Koresh would choose her for sex.
I was so frightened that this thing may happen that I started to flip out, I guess.
But instead of retreating, she wanted to get it over with and decided to knock on his door at about 3 in the morning.
I was offering myself to him.
What does Christ want?
He flew into a rage, claiming God made all his sexual selections. Koresh then woke everyone up and began screaming at Grace in front of the group.
Why? What truth?
It was then that he decided that I needed to be isolated in a cabin.
She says Koresh locked her in a 10-by-8-foot room under 24-hour guard for nearly 4 months. She was fed from a bowl on the floor.
I was treated like a prisoner.
Are you essentially in solitary confinement?
Yeah. My mind did get messed up.
One time, Koresh entered her room and the abuse suddenly turned physical.
He slapped me around on my face.
She says she begged him to let her leave. Koresh refused. Then, when he learned Grace's visa had expired and that immigration authorities may come looking for her, he relented.
God said, you can go now. It's time for you to go.
Grace did leave, but was so traumatized by her experience, she spent more than 2 weeks at a California hospital in a psychiatric ward. Grace then flew home to New Zealand, but her sister stayed behind at the compound, where Koresh was no longer only predicting Armageddon, but preparing for it.